Don Lane, Chill TV, with the PPC candidate, Rob Boganovic. Did I pronounce that name right?
You actually did. Okay. That's good job. Good job.
People's Party of Canada, you're the new guy. You're the newcomer, somewhat controversial, if you will. But when it comes to housing, and that's probably one of the flashpoint issues in Chilliwack, what can you do? What can the PPC do in the local area in the Eastern Fraser Valley?
Yeah. And as I said, for me, the issue is we have to make sure we're solving it on both the supply and the demand side. And a lot of the problems is that we aren't addressing the demand. We're only looking at the supply. And in some cases, solutions that they're being proposing will make the demand side even worse. That's just going to drive up the prices. We looked very hard in the PPC in the early days at the Finnish model. The Finnish model is a housing-first model. Now, we thought it was a great model. It's been working very successfully in Finland. Just because something works in one country doesn't mean it's necessarily going to work here. For one thing, Finland is also the least corrupt country on the planet, right? And so it's always a question of would it translate here to the same level. But we like the logic of it. It's been tried in some places, jurisdictions in the United States as well. But the thing is, it can't be multiple levels, because suppose you are committed to it and you're working with the provinces, and then there's an election and their partners change. Suppose you're committed to it and the provinces are committed to it, and then there's an election and the federal government changes. The individuals who have the vision for it have to basically have that confidence, that security, that's not going to be thrown into chaos. And we believe that that's why we should be giving the tax points to the provinces for all sorts of things, so that they can handle these kinds of issues with the money without coming to the federal government, and let the federal government focus on the things that are of a concern on the national level. Because the situations in Chilliwack, I mean, we saw it as an example, Mark Strahl mentioned this, was how they tried to get funding for the community issues that we had here in Chilliwack, but we didn't qualify because they couldn't categorize this as an urban or rural. And I'm like, okay, that's exactly why this top-down heavy approach is problematic. Communities know their issues. Communities need to have the resources.
There is an addiction ministry with the province of British Columbia. Should there be one with the federal government, or is that, should that just, they, you, the feds stay away from that?
I think that the issue when it comes to addiction is an issue of the law as well, because we have to sort of talk about what would make most sense on the criminalization of various drugs. We actually heard three parties today all say that they want to decriminalize drugs, and maybe they want to decriminalize all drugs. I know that there's a lot of arguments for that. People, for instance, look at Portugal and they say, well, Portugal did it and it worked. Again, what works in one culture might not work in another culture. We can take a look at what happened with Alaska when they, long time ago, legalized marijuana and allowed it to be advertised. It went through the roof. They went back on that. We can take a look at what happened in Colorado when they legalized marijuana. Of course, we've done it on a national level. I think a lot of people who are expecting legalization to look one way are really disappointed with the way it actually looks. All the mama and pop shops got closed down. More people are probably going to jail post-legalization than prior to it, because now we've got the government trying to control the shots. But it is something that belongs on the national level, because it's an issue of crime, right? If we've said that it's criminal to use this drug, to deal, that is a federal issue. But as far as the things that are on the medical side, meaning addiction is a illness, we have to treat it as such, it's a medical situation, that would have to be in the provincial realm. So one side has to be dealing with the law. The other side has to deal with, well, how do you address the medical aspect?
One other thing when it came to seniors care, and it was just briefly touched on, but we're seeing dementia more and more. What can the federal government, say under a PPC leadership, do when it comes to either research, development, care?
Well, this is the thing. One thing that people don't fully know is that our medical systems don't necessarily have available to them all options for treatment. There's a lot of things that are actually blocked from being allowed here, and oftentimes not because they're a big problem, the options aren't available. In the United States, virtually everything that is available for a treatment is available in the United States, but then when you go out from the United States, okay, this isn't here available, this isn't available. My friend who has MS, one of the things that she wants to try is not allowed here, it's not available here, and she looks at that and says, well, why not? Right, it's just arbitrary rules. Now, we have to try and make sure that people have choices, right? And we, the government, should not be getting into the way of those choices. If there's a new experimental treatment individuals want to try, we should be able to allow a means for them to do so, a faint hope, you know, clause kind of thing, because we have individuals who are basically being told the state is going to let you die, or the state is going to allow you, let you suffer, when there is a possibility that something else could be done, and that's a real problem. Now, why I want the provinces to be in control of the funding of healthcare and get the federal government out of it completely is because we've seen how the federal government can just move the math. Now, I support John Diefenbaker, and when he brought forth the promise of 50-50 funding, he helped to bring and create the system with Tommy Douglas, with Lester B. Pearson. Three great leaders in Canada's past all helped to bring that forward. But the system is incredibly expensive, and the system needs to be well managed, and almost every European jurisdiction is doing a better job running their healthcare system than Canada is right now. And one of the reasons for that, and you can just look at the numbers and look at the comparisons, one of the reasons for that, they know who's in charge of the system. The provinces blame the federal government blames the provinces, and the Canadian people don't know who to blame. Well, in 1995, it was pretty easy to know who to blame, Paul Martin. And yet, strangely enough, we praised him for balancing the budget on the backs of the provinces. And that's a real problem.
With the PPC candidate, Don Lane, Chill TV News.